out. I think joining me now on the line from New South Wales, Australia, Dana Trethewey. Is that you, Dana?
Yes, it's Dana.
Dana, hi. It's Nicole Sandler. It's so nice to talk to you. Thank you so much for being willing to do this today. Tell me how to pronounce your name, Diana?
Dana
Trethewey. Yes. And you're in New South Wales, Australia. I was telling the listeners that I happened upon this Facebook group called A View From My Window, and I saw this magnificent picture you posted that to me looked like a painting. And I see two kangaroos looking back at you in a beautiful garden. That's the view from your house?
That is indeed, yes.
That's magnificent.
And there are often more kangaroos
really?
Than that.
Wow. Wow. Now, you're in New South Wales. You guys got hit pretty hard with the fires earlier this year and last year, yes?
Yes. In my area, we didn't get hit. It was the East Coast that got most of the fires and some other areas inland. But in my area, we had a lot of smoke.
I bet. Dead. Wow. Well, it's nice to see that the kangaroos are still there. Are they welcome guests? I know some people here in the States, we have a lot of deer. Not where I live, but deer. And some people look at them as pests. I think they're wonderful. How is it with the kangaroos?
Well, in Australia, they are seen as pests around here. But because I've grown the grass, they come to eat and they leave everything else alone. And we've only got a little sort of family that there are about 8 or 10 of them.
Wow.
And they breed in further out away from the house, and then they just visit and look at us and then go away and then come back next day.
Wow.
They're friends.
Good. Well, they should be. They're part of this world we're living in, which has gotten a whole
yes.
lot smaller in the last couple of months. So
it has. Yes.
What's happening in Australia? I know things are crazy here in the US, and I'm curious to see how the U.S. is handling this mess is being covered over there. But first, I want to hear what's happening in Australia. How is the pandemic affecting you guys over there?
I think it was slightly the same where people didn't really take it seriously, but now they realize that it is serious. And we've got a lot of measures of lockdown and no traveling over Easter and that sort of thing. But initially, I think there was a sort of a perhaps more light-hearted view on it, but it's very serious now. If I went out today anywhere in my car, I would be fined $2,000, I think.
Wow.
Yes, if it was not for a good reason. Yes. It's very strict. Yes.
And that makes sense. Over here, you know, is it the whole nation? Is it the whole country of Australia? Or did the different states have their own rules?
We have different states. In New South Wales, it's very strict. I'm not sure about the other states. But basically, the ease of grouping together has really lessened. So I'm not sure if the other states are as strict as New South Wales.
Question from Judy Truitt in the chat room. She's asking, what town do you live in? She says she has a son in Geelong.
Oh, good heavens. Well, Geelong is about a 20-minute, well, no, maybe an hour, half an hour drive away.
Uh-huh. Small
it's a
world.
Very small place. I'm in Cootamundra.
Cootamundra.
Yes.
Wow. No, I hadn't heard of it before, but it looks beautiful. My husband wanted to know, how far do you have to drive to get to the market?
Oh, to probably no more than 10 minutes.
Oh,
5 to 10 minutes just to go to the town centre.
I got you.
It's actually 4 kilometres from the post office.
Okay.
And that's just in my town, yes.
That's not bad.
But that's a town of about 8,000 or 7,000 people. Roughly.
Wow. That sounds lovely.
Yes.
So we're all stuck here at home. Now, here in the U.S., in 3 weeks, we've had over 17 million people apply for uninsurance compensation to go on the uninsurance rolls because all our jobs are gone. And the government is allegedly doing some kinds of stimulus or rescue packages. Allegedly, we're all going to be getting a $1,200 check deposited into our bank accounts. I think we need that monthly. There's going to be some kind of payroll protection program that they're rolling out. Nothing has happened yet, though. A lot of people are hurting. Are there any provisions like that happening in Australia? Are you being taken care of by the government over there?
Well, people in this country are being taken care of, but access to it is through the internet, and the internet is failing in a lot of ways.
Oh, no.
My husband and I are living off our superannuation, but our son applied for having lost a job, unemployment. Well, he'll be in a queue for a long time. And there are certain people that don't get anything, and then there are others that are getting wages, or their bosses are getting money to help pay for them. So it changes every day, but we are being provided for as a nation more than we thought we would have.
I'm sorry. So one of the biggest problems over here is we do not have universal health care, believe it or not. I don't know if you know how crazy our system is here.
Yes.
But, you know, if we get sick, the first thing they do when you go to the doctor is they ask for your insurance card. And many Americans don't have insurance. And now with millions of people having lost their jobs, in many cases, the insurance is provided to a job. It's tied to their employer. So now we have millions more people who are uninsured. Over there, if you get sick, what happens? Are you automatically covered? Is your health insurance taken care of through taxes?
Our health care is universal here, except refugees don't get it.
Right.
But everyone else does. But regardless of their income or regardless if they have a job or not, we are, I think, probably one of the few countries in the world that have universal health care in our country. And most Australians, some Australians don't actually realise that the USA doesn't have that. We just take it for granted, I think. But we are always covered. We also have private insurance for special medical things that we might like to have through the private system. And I have access to that as well. But if I didn't have that and I was dying, I would be saved in a public hospital. So you are... your country is deficient in the basic care, in my opinion.
Yes, we are.
Absolutely. Now, totally appalling.
So many things are appalling about what goes on here.
Yes,
so that's my other question for you, Diana, is I'm wondering what kind of coverage of this disaster and how the United States has handled it are you seeing over there? I'm wondering because we're seeing an administration that denied the severity of this virus for weeks, putting us way behind the ball. So testing wasn't done, and now the explosion we're seeing is about a half a million cases already in the U.S., more than double the next closest nation in the planet. It's exploding here, and while the rest of the world, it seems to be fairly much under control.
Yes, well, it's astounding to many of us in this country that actually pay attention that your administration has been so flippant about it, and particularly, say, with this new drug that is supposed to be brilliant, and yet the people who need it for immune diseases like lupus not being able to access that drug it's a little bit of gossip, really, isn't it, saying a certain drug might help?
Yes,
now,
it's horrible.
Most of us are appalled. Many don't seem to notice, but I think that's the case in most countries where people just don't really notice what's happening beyond their fence. But, it's... I've lost my train of thought.
That's okay,
now
but you have the same impression of our leadership as we do. Most of us, and I hope you know that, you know, more people voted against Donald Trump than voted for him. Unfortunately, more people than voted entirely didn't vote at all. So we have a very apathetic public over here, and hopefully, everyone will come to their senses this November and get him out of office.
That is also beyond my comprehension because it's compulsory to vote in this country. And if you don't, you're fined.
Wow.
So it's and then people still don't understand that they have a right to vote, but when they do have to vote and they haven't been paying attention, they just pick, you know, a popular name or ask the person, who do I vote for? So you're still having disengaged people here, but it's, you know, we watch your politics on TV.
I'm sorry.
Yes.
Yeah, we are in hell. We are truly, truly in hell. And it's one of the reasons why I like to reach out to people around the world. One, to apologize for foisting this madman on the rest of the world. And seriously, I've been mortified for the last 3.5 years and just embarrassed on the world stage that this country would have put this man in power. And what he's done to this nation and now to the planet is just atrocious. And so on behalf of my fellow Americans, I apologize to you and everyone else on the planet. And hopefully my fellow Americans will do the smart thing in November and get him out of there. Because I think it's our only hope.
I completely agree with you, yes.
All right.
We're all watching.
Well,
all the best.
Well, thank you so much, Diana. It was a pleasure to meet you. If you wanted to say anything to America from Australia, what would you tell them?
Just don't forget that if you don't save your planet, then we all die.
You got that right. On that final note, how are the fires over there? Are things getting better, or are we still in danger once it heats up again?
Well, we've got people, whilst this pandemic is occurring, there are state forests being cut down. And so this is all going on without the public being told.
Wow.
And a lot of the fires that apparently there, where the fires burnt out the forests and the habitats have gone, they're starting to log those forests, which means the habitats will even go further. So all this sort of stuff is happening under the radar. Mm. So that's the treachery of politics is still occurring here too.
Yeah, it's horrible. There was a book written a few years ago by a woman named Naomi Klein called The Shock Doctrine. And it is about how governments take these crises, these horrific events, and use them to their advantage. When things go bad, when there's a bad earthquake or a devastating a hurricane or something, how the governments then use that to basically wipe out the common folk and put in charter schools or take over all the public systems and stuff. And I fear that this is going to happen on a global level with this pandemic. So we all need to be on our best.
I think it is
awareness.
Happening. Yeah. Yes, for sure.
Wow.
I really do. Because when as you say, when everybody's eyes on one thing, that's a great opportunity to do all those other things.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah.
Yeah. So we need to be on our... we need to stay on our toes and be vigilant and not let the bastards win, basically.
I agree.
Right? Diana, what a pleasure talking to you. I look forward to exchanging words on Facebook. And I love your photo. And it was great to meet you. And hopefully one of these days we'll meet in person.
I agree. Yes.
Thank you so very much. You take care.
Okay.
All right. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.